Now, if you thought the toddler tantrums were hard to deal with, just wait till they hit their teens. Young adults can think they know it all, and suddenly they have the power to act upon any impulse they like. Here to give us some advice, parenting advisor Yvonne Godfrey and 16-year-old Shaun Olsen. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
I remember myself. I was a horrific teenager. I was a nasty piece of work. I'm surprised my parents spoke to me at all through those years. Shaun, do you see your friends or your schoolmates making bad decisions and getting into trouble?
Sometimes. I had an example for... I had this friend in Year 9. We were really good mates, and then as we started to get older, we started hanging out with different crowds. He got into the drinking and different things like that and started to get off course, and now his grades, unfortunately, have been affected, and it's not very good.
And that can happen very easily, unfortunately. Yvonne, why do you think some kids do go off the rails a little bit?
They lose their hope and their vision for the future. They're confused about where they're going, and that can be caused by trauma or just not having coping skills. They don't know how to handle problems. And lastly, they've just got weak character. You know, they've been allowed to get away with too much, and it becomes the entitlement zone for them.
Yes, I can understand that. Shaun, is pushing the boundary something that we should just expect as parents? I mean, should parents just, like, step back a bit?
Yes, they should, to a certain extent, but not so much that if they start to go off track that the parents can't control them. They should just step back enough so if we do start to lose our way, they're there not to push us back to place, but to guide us and support us.
That's true. But sometimes, though, the parents don't actually know that the child is going off the rails because they hide it, because they're little schemers. They can be quite good at that, can't they, Yvonne?
I think a good parent sees the signs, and I think the most important thing for parents is to keep that relationship with their children, to keep them talking so that you do know what's going on, asking the right questions so that you know what's going on. And I think most parents are aware, and they need to be aware.
Well, that's the thing, is you need to keep them talking, because teenagers can be notoriously surly and a little bit quiet as well. Is there something that we can do to help our teens choose the right friends? Because quite often as a parent you feel that maybe they're being guided down the wrong path by
influenced
their
by
peers.
Everybody else. Look, one of the greatest things you can do is make your home the go-to place. So if their friends are coming home to your place, you get a chance to assess them, to check out whether they're with good or bad company. And in that, you can influence them. I remember having wonderful chats with my girls' friends, and they loved it because I was a good person to talk to. Yeah. So being there. And then if they've got a friend that you think is probably not so good, I used to ask my girls, so tell me, like, what do you like about that person? And they have to go, oh, let me think, what's good about that person? And sometimes they're very shallow answers, and they were attracted to that person for all the wrong reasons. So then you could just, in a conversational way, say, you know, is that really good?
Yeah.
And let them tell you.
Yes, okay. They've got to make the decisions. You've got to make them think that they're making the decisions. That's what it is, isn't it?
I think it's good, because then they own them.
Shaun, do you think that parents do tend to overreact a bit or react in a way that could maybe make the situation worse?
Yes, I do. It really just depends who the parent is. So if they overreact, it tends to make the kids not want to communicate and talk to their parents to work it out. They just want to keep annoying them, because they're going to get told off anyway, so to them it doesn't matter. So I guess that's how they see it from their point of view.
You seem very grounded for a 16-year-old.
Thank you.
Yes, your mum and dad must be doing something right.
I'd like to think so. Pretty good.
So are they.
That's
so
why
they.
I chose him. He's just amazing.
Yeah, extraordinary. Can you come and be friends with all of my children? What should we tell a young teen about drugs and alcohol? Because obviously once they hit high school, things change quite dramatically. What should we be telling them about it?
I think we should tell them the truth. And we need to be educated to do that. We need to be up on what's the reality. Instead of just making these grandiose, dramatic stories about that to scare them, which I think reduces your credibility. And the other thing is, if you've had a drug and alcohol past yourself, don't glamorise it. Because some parents do that to make themselves look fabulous.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, in my day. So you've got to be a good role model.
It's not
easy to talk to kids about drugs and alcohol if you're overindulging.
So underlining all the stories you see where children have or young people have had horrible consequences with alcohol and leaving them out on the table is not a good idea?
Sorry, leaving...
Like, say there's a story about someone who's maybe died or something from overuse
of
alcohol.
So that's truth.
Letting them see those stories is a good thing too?
If you can point to some things that really have happened, I think that's really good. But I know parents that make up these extraordinary stories just as a shock value that are not true. So... Yeah.
Blanket fact that it's all evil. No, they've just got to learn how to what's right and what's wrong.
Look, people do whatever people are going to do. So we've got to educate our kids in a calm way, in a real way. But also there needs to be consequences, and I think parents need to make sure the kids are not in dangerous situations.
Yeah.
If you let your kids stay up till 2 o'clock in the morning and tell them not to get into trouble...
Chances are they're going to get into trouble.
Amen.
So, Shaun, finally, what do you think, what do you wish parents would do more of?
Trust us. I'd have to say that would be the biggest thing, because if they trust us and they can trust us to go out and do things, then we'll mutually respect them, and then I guess that'll lead to a good relationship between you and your parents.
Trust, and I guess on the other side of that is that the teenager also has to earn that trust, don't they?
Yes.
Fantastic. Well, that's been a very interesting, insightful talk for me. Thank you both so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.